lord and king and less than kind.
Tell me, why is it the spice that hangs on you?
Not so, my lord, I am too much in the sun.
Hamlet, cast thy knight of colour off, and let thy knight look like a friend on Manchester.
Do not forever with thy veiled lids seek for thy noble father in the dust.
And now is this common? All that lives must die.
Hath it to nature to eternity?
Aye, it is common.
It's sweet and commendable in your nature, Hamlet, to give these mourning duties to your father. But you must know that your father lost a father. That father lost his, and the survivors are bound in some filial obligation to do some term of obsequious sorrow, but to persevere in obstinate condolement. It's of course impious stubbornness. It's an unmanly grief. It shows a will most incorrect of the heavens, a heart unfortified, a mind impatient, an understanding simple and unschooled. For what we know must be, and is any most vulgar thing to sense. So why should we take it to heart? We pray you, throw to the earth this unprevailing woe, and think of us as a father. For let the world take note that you are the most immediate to our throne, of no less nobility of love than that which the dearest father bears his own son, the I impart towards you. Your intent in going back to school in London, it's most retrograde the our desire. So we beseech you, bend you remain here, in the cheer and comfort of our eye, our chief disquieter, cousin, and my son.
Hamlet, I pray thee, let not thy mother lose her prayers. Stay here with us, and not to London.
I will, and all my best,
obey you. Well, it's a loving and fair reply. This gentle, unfortunate court of Hamlet's, it's smiling to my heart. Come away, madam.
Two solid flesh would melt. Thought and resolve itself into a dew. Oh, that the everlasting had not fixed his cunning against self-slaughter. Oh God. Oh God! How weary, stale, flat, and unprofitable seem to me the uses of this world. Fie on it. Oh, fie! 'Tis an unweeded garden, the grosser seed, things rank and gross in nature possessing merely. That it should come to this. But 2 months dead, nay, not so much, not two. So excellent a king that was to this, a Hyperion to a satyr. So loving to my mother that he might not, beteem the winds of heaven, bitter her face too roughly. Heaven and earth, must I remember? Why she would hang on him as his increase of appetite had grown by what it had fed on. And yet within a month, let me not think on it, oh, frail did that naked woman! A little month away the shoes for all that she followed my poor father's body. Like Niobe, all tears. Oh God, she, even she, a beast that wants this cause of reason would have mourned longer. Married with my uncle, my father's brother, but no more like a father than I to Hercules. A little month away the souls of most unrighteous tears and thus flushing in her golden eyes, she married. Oh, such wicked speed, to pose with such dexterity to incestuous sheets. It is not, nor it cannot, come to any good. But break my heart, for I must hold my tongue.
Aye, spring just the catch woodcocks. I I do know when the blood burns, how prodigal the soul lends the tongue vows. These praises, daughter, giving more light than heat, extinct in both, even in the promise you must not take for fire. From this time be somewhat scanter of your maiden presence. Say your treatments are a higher rate than the command of Pondray. For Lord Hamlet believes so much in him that he is young, and with a larger tether may he walk than me beginning you. In Ophelia, do not believe his vows, for they are brokers. Will not die which their investments show, but mere implorators of unholy suits, breathing like sanctified and pious balls. The better to beguile, this for all I would not, in plain terms, from this time forth have you so slandered. Any moment leisure earth to give words or talk to the Lord Hamlet. Look to it, I charge you, my daughter. Come your ways. Farewell, Ophelia, and remember well what I have said to you.
Take arms against the sea of troubles, and by opposing, end them.
die, to sleep, a chance to dream. In that sleep, who knows what dreams may come once we have shuffled off this mortal coil. But fair something after death, the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveller returns.
Good Hamlet, how does your honour this many day?
I humbly thank you well.
Hamlet, I have remembrances of yours that I have long to redeliver. I pray you now receive them.
But I never gave you aught.
You're not right what you did. Which gives much more than gives the wrong guy.
So there. Get thee to an honour. Why wouldst thou be a breeder in sinners? I could accuse myself of such things, that it were best that my mother had not for me. I have heard of your paintings too. God has given you one face and you make yourself another. They have made me mad. To an honour. Oh, go!
They should lay him in the cold ground.
poison of deep grief. It springs all from her father's death.
Other vile king! Give me my father.
Calmly, good Ares.
That drop of blood that's come proclaims me bastard. Where is my father?
He's dead, but not by me.
How can he dead? Let come what comes only out of a vengeful sternly for my father.
Oh, you never face nothing big. Hey, nonny, nonny. Nonny, nonny, hey. And in his grave rain many a tear. Fare you all, my dog.
Dear maid, kind sister, sweet Ophelia. Oh heavens, it's possible a young maid's wit should be as mortal as an old man's life.
You must sing Adam, Adam. And you must call him Adam.
Thoughts and remembrance, fitted.
There's a daisy for you. I would give you some violets, but they all withered away when our father died. He said he made a good end. Oh, bonny sweet Robin is all my joy.
That's an affliction, passion, hell itself she turns into favor, into prettiness.
And will he not come again? And will he not come again? No, no, he is gone. Go to thy deathbed. His beard was white as snow. Of flotsam was his bow, and we must cast away our moan. God have mercy on his soul.
Oh God, do you see this?
Laertes, I must commune with your grief, or deny me right. If you're content in lending your patience to us, we shall labor jointly with your soul to give due content. For put me in your heart, he which hath your noble father slain also pursued my life.
It well appears, but tell me, why are you proceeding not against these fates?
Two special reasons, his mother, the queen, and for myself.
I have a noble father lost. A sister driven into desperate terms. But my revenge will come.
Was your father dear to you, or are you painting a sorrow, a face without a heart?
Why you ask this?
What would you undertake to prove yourself your father's son in deeds more than word?
To cut his throat in the church.
Revenge should have no bounds. You may take a weapon, an unveiled weapon, on the pass of practice. Requite him for your father.
I'll do it. And for that purpose, I'll anoint my weapon. That if I gall him slightly, it may be death.
And if he asks for a drink, I shall prepare him a chalice of the nonce. Whereupon sipping, if he by chance escape your venom struck, our purpose will hold there.
Your sister's drawing, Laertes.
Drowned. Drowned where?
She fell in the weeping brook. Her garments heavy with their drink pulled the poor wretch to her lip melodiously into muddy death.
Alas, then she is drowned. Too much of water hast thou, poor Ophelia. Therefore I forbid her tears.
Oh, who is he whose grief bears such an emphasis? Whose phrase of sorrow conjures up the wandering stars and makes them stand like wonder-wounded heroes? This is I, Hamlet.
The devil take thy soul!
Thou praise not well. I pray thee, take thy fingers from my throat. Though I am not splendid but rash, have I in me something dangerous which let thy wisest spear hold off my hand?
I've flung them asunder.
Hamlet! Hamlet! I will fight with thee.
yet. This gains my conscience.
Come, Laertes, you but dally. Pass with your best violence. I bid you make a wanton of me.
Say you so? Come on, have at it now.
Nay, come again.
I must be killed with my own treachery.
How does this weep?
She swims to see you bleed.
Yeah.